Hello everyone and welcome to another PC Part Picker live stream. I'm Ryan.
And I'm Barry.
And today we have a special treat for you. We're putting together a water-cooled machine, both the CPU and the GPU, inside of Fractal's newly released Define R6 Tempered Glass Edition.
Yes.
Big thanks to Fractal for providing the case, MSI for providing the motherboard for this build, and Corsair for providing their RGB fans.
Yep.
Let's get started.
Alrighty. Alright, we're gonna do things a little bit differently today, Ryan. We've got a lot of case deconstruction to do.
Okay.
Since we're putting a 360 rad in the top, we're putting a 120mm rad down at the bottom for the GPU. So we're going to go ahead and take this thing fully apart.
All right.
So the side panels have just four thumb screws. They don't stay in. They pop out. But Fractal says that you really don't need them because they've got this nice kind of just push in and click. So if you're not traveling or anything like that, then you can do it. Also, tempered glass. And no Frankenstein bolts.
Yes, yeah, so. And it's kind of got like a little black outline on it too.
Yeah, so it's got a metal frame around it. And then the back side panel is exactly the same way. It's basically just got little clips that it clips into up here at the back and then slides in the front. And then this has the nice sound dampening. Yep, the top also comes out, so it's just got this big giant button in the back. You push it, pops the top up.
There you go.
It's a little bit heavier now. And then it comes off solid piece. And then what you do is you just pop this out. There we go. We have a top filter. And then this is the kind of silence it. So if you're not using fans or radiator or anything like that up top, just keep some of the noise in.
Yeah.
And then the filter would just pop back in. You know, stylistically, I kind of like it, but that's going to be opinionated. Mm-hmm. So the front is a hinge door. Similar to the R5.
Right.
It's got a 5 1/4 inch optical bay up here in case you have either a CD drive or like a hot swappable SSDs or something like that. So we will be removing it though. Made a mistake. I should have taken out the bottom filter first. Let me pull it out real quick. There we go. Bottom filter, full bottom. So not just partly. And then it's also got another filter right here for the front fans, and it comes with three 140mm Fractal fans.
Okay.
We're going to be putting a 360mm rad at the top.
Right.
So we could put it in without taking this bracket out. Makes it a whole lot easier for me to take the bracket out.
Okay.
So it's simply four screws. Let's see here. Four screws right here, 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 and here that just come out. And then you can just take this out and have ease of putting in any sort of radiator, I think all the way up to a 420mm.
Yeah, it'll do up to a 420 on top. The only limitation there is that the components on your motherboard have to be under 35mm.
Right.
So if you have taller memory, that might be an issue.
Yes. Also, this is kind of neat.
Yes.
Unique to the case. It's got a fill port. So if you're doing a custom loop in here, you have an easy spot without drilling holes in your case. They've already put a nice little fill port here for you that you can actually fill your res without going through lots and lots of odd angles. And
weird angles or like a funnel off to the side with a tube coming down or, you know, kind of hacked together scenarios. It's really good forethought on their end.
All right. And as you can also see, we have a slew of optical bays. It comes with six. It looks like I think there's room for 11 if you were going to turn this into a NAS or you just have a lot of old hard drives that you want to keep in here, along with two 2.5-inch mounts.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to go ahead and remove these. The case has two layouts, essentially a standard layout, which is what you see. You've got this right here where the hard drives were back here. But they give you the option of moving this to the back to give you a more open layout.
Right.
And since we're gonna be putting a rad in the bottom, another radiator up top, and then we're using an EATX motherboard, we're gonna go ahead and move this to the back just to open it up, give us optimal airflow, plenty of room also for our radiator to fit. So to do that though, you have to take out, first we'll take out the optical drive cage. And we'll take out the two 140mm fans, and then we'll take this piece and we'll move it back.
Okay.
Basically, the optical drive is just held in with two screws. Just take those out real quick. And then we're gonna remove these two fans, and we're just removing these fans temporarily. It's just because we can't move this piece right here back with the fan still there. It kind of stuff is a little bit tight when it moves back, and the cables can kind of get pinched, and you can't really route the cables the way that they've kind of given you a little cutout for. So it's just easier just to get them out of the way instead of struggling with it to try to fit it in there. All right. This piece out right here, there are two screws at the top. There are two screws at the front, and then there's two screws at the bottom.
Okay.
So the two screws at the top are different from the two screws on the front and on the bottom. So I don't think you can mix them up, but just be aware that the screws on the top are different. There's two. Take this out. So if you didn't want this in, if you were doing some crazy custom loop with a couple reservoirs or something like that, this is all the room that you've got.
Mm-hmm.
As you can see here, here is our vertical GPU mount. I don't know if you can really tell how much spacing is right there, but it is more than we've generally seen with a vertical mount.
Right.
Fractal is kind enough to send us one in the kit. This is going to be available late January of 2018. And I think it's going to retail for roughly, I believe, $40.
Yeah, that one is $40.
Yep. So, and what it does is it comes with the riser cable, nicely sleeved Fractal Design logo on it, and then it comes with standoffs and screws to actually attach the riser to this. So you would basically just attach it to your motherboard and then attach it down here. And there's a screw hole here and here that it basically sets in. And then there you go.
And to me, that's the most important part, because the missing functionality from a lot of cases that do have vertical GPU mounts is that they don't have a way to mount a riser bracket for support onto the shroud, and that is built into the case and this riser.
Yep.
Well, we have a special question slash challenge, potentially.
Oh, okay.
Okay. From our favorite user, Fractal Josh,
is
in the chat today. He was asking, how do you think you guys would do trying to build a PC in a moving van?
In a moving
Vehicle of some kind. Not a van, a vehicle, so much more dangerous.
Moving vehicle of some kind. How do I think I'd do? I think we would fare pretty well.
Yeah. Unless this moving vehicle is like that zero-G plane.
Yeah, unless you're talking about the Vomit Comet.
Yes.
Which I think puts you in zero gravity for roughly 8 minutes.
Yeah.
And I don't know how fast I could build in that.
Yeah.
But I mean, I guess we'd give it a try. I'm sure Josh has plenty of evil things up his sleeve.
I'm sure he does.
All right, now I'm slightly scared.
Yeah, I know.
All right, while we're on the front of the case, it does have two spots. So it comes with the two 2.5-inch mounts in the back. You can take those in case you have nice SSDs that you want to show off. Basically got little brackets that you slot them down into, and then just with the thumb screw, just attach them. Pretty simple.
Yeah.
It does come with a fan hub for, I think, 6 3-pin fans. It is a PWM fan header, but it comes with 6 3-pin fans, and then I believe 3 4-pin PWM fans.
Mm-hmm.
Comes with two USB 2.0 reset headphone jack, microphone. So the reset switch, I like it because it's really hard to hit. Ryan is not so much of a fan of it because
it's too hard for my big fingers.
It's too hard for him to hit. So that's preference. I would rather not accidentally hit it.
Right.
However, while we're talking about it, the one thing this case does not have is Type-C. Fractal, I think, realizes, and Josh could probably attest to this, that not everybody has Type-C, but they realize some people do, so they're offering a kit that's going to be available first quarter of next year. That will actually add Type-C to your case. So if you're a user or you're somebody that uses Type-C, whether it's for a hard drive or something like that, and your motherboard supports it, you can get basically a new front I/O.
Right, it replaces the whole front section.
Yeah, it replaces. So if you don't have to worry about drilling holes or anything like that, they send you a new shield. I think you remake use of buttons, of your power button and your USB.
Mm-hmm.
They screw out pretty easy, and then you just replace the section over here. It's got Type-C, and you're good to go. All right, so start putting the case back together. We're gonna put this panel back in. What you do is you just slot it in here. You're gonna line it up, and it's not gonna go fully underneath the rails for where the radiator are. It's actually gonna mount to that a little bit later once we get there. But you'll basically take these two screws, and then just like on this side, there's two holes on this side that you will screw them back into. And then, just like on the bottom, basically the same thing. You've got two holes right here and right here. Mm-hmm. On the front, another reason to take out the cables, or to take out the fans, is there's a little slot right here made into this front panel that you can kind of slot the fan cables through, so you can get nice cable management. Some people don't care about it. Some people are OCD about it. I'm not going to say which one I am. So we'll pull these back through and attach these fans, and I'm going to attach them roughly in the same location they were. So case deconstruction done. Like I said, we do still have to screw this into the top up here. We'll get to that when we get to the radiator, so it's just gonna kind of set around, but it's secure right now. So I'm gonna hand this off to you, Ryan.
Okay.
So we're using the Z370 Godlike Gaming from MSI.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a beast of a motherboard before I start. Antistatic.
Antistatic wrist strap, yep.
And then here's everything that it comes with.
Right.
So our manual, I'm gonna stick off to the side just in case we need it. Comes with an IO shield, and IO shield is blank, but they give you three magnetic.
Nice.
Kind of.
Not a sticker, thank you.
Yeah, not a sticker. So you can kind of, you know, if you're not black and red, you throw it away. If you are black and red, you keep it. A couple different designs, just a nice little touch. We're also going to be using, they include a rainbow strip they'll be using. It's addressable RGBs, so very nice there. Also, just because they're cool at the very end of the build, we're gonna put on these little tridents, I guess. These are our Wi-Fi antennas.
Yeah.
So we'll stick those over there. And then, if we wanted to do something super crazy and just throw all the M.2s, it has three spots for M.2 on the board, and then also an additional two using a PCIe card.
Right.
We're not gonna get that crazy today. So. And then, you know, it's a nice little goodie bag with just a slew of other stuff in it. We have thermistors, we have braided and colored SATA cables, which I've got our SATA cable over here. Stick with the theme of the build, we're gonna be using black and gray.
Mm-hmm.
It's got a headphone adapter because it's got a built-in DAC with a 6.3 millimeter headphone adapter. It also comes with, this is one of my favorite things, so it's got three USB 2 ports or headers already, just in case you have an insane amount of USB 2 devices you need to hook up. It comes with an expansion slot or an expansion card, so you can add even more. So lots of nice little touches.
Yeah, the USB header coverage on this board is very nice. You have three 2.0s, you have two 3.0s or 3.1s, and then you also have the 3.1 Gen 2. For when you have that Type-C.
Yeah, for when you have that Type-C
cable at the front of your case. And really, just about anything you can imagine is on that board.
Yes. And since it's such a high-end board, we're going to be using the new Coffee Lake 8700K. i7, 6 cores, 12 threads.
Basically the best CPU for gaming at the moment.
Right. Get your CPU ready.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to lift the latch, lift up the cover. We're going to match the gold triangle on our CPU to our little pin 1 indicator on the motherboard.
Mm-hmm.
We're just going to drop it in there and close the cover. Pops off, and you're done.
Easy peasy.
For RAM, 32 gigabytes of DDR4, 3000 megahertz, RGB. So the case did not come with any RGB, so we're going to add our own.
Right.
All right, so we'll make sure all these are open. And we don't really have to worry about order too much because we're populating all four slots. You just want to make sure that you line up the notch in the RAM with the notch on the motherboard. Make sure you have it facing the right direction. And then just slot it in. Push down and it clicks. And now you just need to repeat that. There we go. For storage, we're using the Samsung 960 Pro NVMe 1 terabyte. We have three options to put it in. Our graphics card is going to go in the top slot. We're going to put it down here in the bottom slot, just to get it away from all the heat. Not that the graphics card is actually going to have a lot of heat in this build. Let's switch out screw tip here. So, and all of the M2s on this board, even the ones on the card, have MSI's M2 shield, which has a little thermal pad on it to help dissipate some of the heat on the top side. So we'll take that screw out. We'll just lift it up here. And you'll notice they've got this little cover helping protect the thermal pad. So you just take it, slot it in. And then with this, you just kind of, let's
see here. It just kind of pops onto pegs on the side.
Yep, it's got pegs on the side. There we go. We'll just take it, push down. Almost done with our motherboard, but before we completely get rid of it, we're going to go ahead and put the back plate on for our CPU cooler. And our CPU cooler that we're going to be using is the Fractal Design S36.
It's a big one.
Yeah. So now I'm just going to pull out this and these for now.
The cooler's compatible with all the modern motherboard layouts, sockets, AM4, AM3.
Yeah.
You know, LJ115X, 20XX.
X299, X399, so
yeah,
it's good for everything. You will want to make sure that the pegs are slid down to the innermost corners, and then we'll stick these off to the side. Use that to attach it. Basically just lift it up. Put in the holes, lower it back down, and then you just screw these in.
Nice.
All right. So I've got that on. We're done with our motherboard. Before we completely move on, because then we'll be putting the motherboard in the case, a couple more features of the board. If you have a ton of fans in your case, this motherboard is for you, because it has 1, 2 at the bottom. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 at the side. We have our CPU fan header, and then we have another header right here, which is for a pump.
And two more right there.
And then two more right there. So if you have a ton of fans, don't worry about you know, running out of space to plug them in.
Well, the nice thing for, in my mind, is that it's very flexible, too. So depending on where your fans are, you won't necessarily have to use extensions or anything.
Right.
Because it is an EATX board, so it may end up in larger cases if you're not using
Define R6. Exactly. Everything else, I believe, can stay in because we are using different fans. We're not going to use the Fractal fans.
Right.
We're going to add even more RGB to this, and we're going to use fans that I'm getting ready to get out. The Corsair ML120 Pros. So these are controllable. It comes with the Lighting Node Pro and the connector and everything like that that you need. So we'll be using this. Detach these on there just to give our case some extra lighting options. Again, with RGB, you don't always have to go full rainbow or anything like that. You just dial in the color that you want. We like having the option of doing that, so that's where we're going to use these. Here, in the top of it, basically going to save off to later. This has our controller and everything like that to be able to control the fans.
Right.
Also, I'm going to go ahead and bring back up here our bracket that we'll be attaching the radiator to. First thing you want to do, if you hadn't already done it, is you want to figure out your orientation of your radiator in the case.
Right.
Our pipes are going to be at the front of the case, so switch this around like this, and we're going to be exhausting air out of the case, out through the top of the case. So we're going to put our fans, basically where the cables go along the back. If you notice, these fans have extra cables because they also have the RGB control.
Right.
So we'll move this out of the way. And we have used this cooler before, so the thermal paste is not pre-applied.
Right.
So but we keep the cover on there just to protect it.
It normally would be.
It normally would be, correct. So we'll get these lined up here. And when screwing these in like this, I suggest, again, going in crisscross. Don't fully tighten them down until you have the two in, and then the other two corners just go in together. And also, with the S36, it's got the built-in fan hub at the top, mm-hmm. so there's just one plug that we plug in, so we will go ahead and plug in the fans to that. Okay, all right. So our fan cables are there to keep me from going crazy when trying to put this in. Corsair in their kit has two small, tiny little zip ties.
Very nice.
And I just found the perfect use for them. And let's cook this off real quick. All right. The bracket is a little bit different than brackets have been in the past. With as far as where you can mount, usually they have one side that's strictly for 280, mm-hmm. and then another side that you kind of share with 280, use it for 360, 240, something like that. This one, you can kind of use either or for the 360, which is important because with using 360, we are using taller RAM, mm-hmm. So we want to make sure that we use the forward most. Front of the case would be this way, the forward most slot. So it would be this one and then this one to make sure we get our clearance for our RAM.
Right.
We're gonna pull this up here. Again, you also wanna make sure that you don't put it the wrong way. Always flat side, always against the radiator. And then I would suggest also when you screw it in, and it's not too hard to adjust it once it's in the case, but if you do look like you're running in the clearance, kind of just loosen a couple of the screws, that way you can slide it back and forth. The rails do provide a lot of room to be able to slide it. And then you can adjust it that way.
Mm-hmm.
Power supply, next little piece. We're using the Corsair RM850X, and we're also using custom sleeve cables.
Yep,
from CableMont. So I've kind of already cheated. I've taken the power supply out of the box, so I'm gonna put this back down here. And here is our power supply.
Yeah, it's fully modular, obviously.
Yeah, fully modular.
And we are using full cables, not extensions.
Yeah, again, to go with our theme. Mm-hmm. They're black and white. I've kind of also cheated again. Those are the ones that we need.
Yep.
It comes with...
It comes with a full kit.
Yeah, it comes with a full kit. So it comes with every extra cable, just like the power supply would. And then Ryan, if you don't mind, just because I forgot, if you can take off the power supply bracket off the back of the case. It should just be two thumb screws.
I'll see if I can do that. Sounds pretty difficult.
Thank you.
It's a standard bracket.
Yep. Just your standard bracket. We'll put that on last. We'll plug in our cables first. We're going to start with 24 pin. Have our 8-pin, and with this build, it is actually an 8 plus 4, so we will need 2 8-pin connectors.
Right, EPS and an ATX
yep.
power cable.
PCIe cable.
Yep. Two PCIe cables.
Yep, helps if you plug in the correct side.
Yeah, and are those both 8-pins or 6 plus 2s?
Both of these are 6 plus 2s, and our graphics card is a 8 plus 6.
Okay.
So, and then we will also need SATA because we are putting in a traditional 3.5-inch drive.
Right.
And then we'll also need SATA to power our fan hub,
mm-hmm.
our controller for the RGB hub, and then the Lighting Node Pro.
Right.
Right there. That's everything connected to the power supply. I forgot to take the accessories out earlier. We've got our typical bag of screws. Includes everything for mounting hard drives, SSDs, the motherboard, the power supply.
Right, and this is from the case.
Yeah, this is from the case. Also comes with a nice microfiber cloth, keeps your tempered glass clean,
mm-hmm.
and 6 zip ties. I'll probably need more than 6 when I cable manage it this time.
Later. Yeah.
But we'll see. So then with this, basically just line it up with our power supply. All right, so that is everything that we can do outside of the case.
All right.
So now we're gonna basically go in reverse order, kind of semi-reverse order. If you can hand me the case.
Yes, sir.
We are gonna put the power supply in first because we are using an EATX motherboard. It does cover some of the grommets. right here. So what we want to make sure is we want to go ahead and put in the power supply now and then go ahead and pre-route some of our cables. That way we're not running into trouble once we get the motherboard in. I'm going to actually go ahead and pre-route the USB 3 cable because that is also a thicker cable that I want to get out of the way. Basically just bundle your cables together. Pushing through, we are fan on the, our power supply, intake cold air through the bottom of the case, exhaust it out the back, so we're putting the fan down.
Yeah, because there is a nice gap and there's a dust filter.
Yes. So we get that in there, and then you just secure it with these thumb screws. There we go. We're gonna take our 24 pin, kind of try to get it free of any of the other cables for right now.
Right.
I'm just gonna go ahead and take that. We're going to set it up here, and we will also go ahead and route our 8-pin just to go ahead and get it in the position.
Yeah, the 8 and the 4-pin.
Yeah, the 8 and the 4-pin.
One thing to note is that if you do use an EATX motherboard like this one, you may have to use custom cables if you want to use the grommets.
Right.
Because if you have thickly sleeved cables, especially the 24-pin, you're not going to be able to fit it in the gap.
Right.
With at least with the grommets in place, you may be able to squeak out a little bit of extra space by removing the grommets.
Right.
But there are other ways to get the cable there.
Yeah, you can either have this all the way forward if you need to and just bring the cable over that way or
just remove it entirely.
Yeah. Our standoffs are pre-installed. It does come with a nice standoff post.
Yes.
Greatly appreciated. And we need to install our IO-ship.
And this one is padded on the back.
Yeah, it is padded on the back.
Fantastic.
I'm going to go with mostly black. That's good with you, Ryan?
Yep.
So, and this is literally just a magnet. So it just snaps right on there and you're good to go. 4 snaps and it's in. Just slide this down in here.
There we go. Good.
I'm gonna go ahead and I've got our SATA cable. I'm gonna push it through to the back. I'm gonna push in some other front IO. I'm gonna take the USB 2 cable that we use to control our RGB fans. Stick that, hook up the USB 3, USB 2, all of that fun stuff. But I'm gonna go ahead and push it through now before I start adding in the radiator and the graphics card, just because things start to get kind of tight.
Right.
We also have, we're gonna stick our fan header through four. For our fan hub, because we will be plugging in the case fans to the fan hub. So go ahead and push this through. Actually, probably easier if I did it this way. And I'm gonna just go ahead and attach that right here at it. We've got our HD audio, our USB 2 for the case, and our front I.O.
Okay.
And I'm going to route these through. There's a little spot right here for the front I.O.
Right. And that is one thing we actually didn't mention earlier, and you'll be able to see here in a second when we actually plug them in. But the grommeted routing for the I.O. panel, the USB headers, and then there is an opening as well for the HD audio cable as well. Great, great features to see in a Shroud. Expected.
There we go. Our USB 2. I'm going to go ahead and route the USB 2 for fans in here also. Let's see here. And then our HD audio. I'm going to try to snake it behind some of this stuff just to make life easier later.
There you go.
I'm going to do the hardest cable first. Went in way easier than I expected.
There you go.
There we go.
All right.
Right here we have our fan cable for our hub in the back. So we're actually going to plug it in right here. We'll take our 24 pin. Support the motherboard a little bit. Our USB 3, and you're going to kind of have to pull it out a little bit and then push it back in. Can't make that angle.
too much. Do our HD audio. And then we have our USB for the case. USB 2 header for the case.
Yes.
We have our USB 2 header for our RGB control for the fans.
Right.
Then we have our front I/O.
Yes, all of those. The switches, the LEDs.
Yes. And
it's not wrote on the motherboard. So, refer to our motherboard manual.
Yep.
We'll start with our hard drive, LED, power LED. We got our reset switch. Then lastly, our power switch. Fit those back down in there a little bit.
Now, we're going to put our cooler in the top. It's always confusing when you're looking at it, trying to figure out which way it's supposed to go in. Yes. Yeah, fill ports at the back.
Fill ports in the right spot.
All
right.
Yeah. So what I'm also going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and stick our RGB for the fan in through the back. Because once we put this radiator in.
Yeah, good luck routing those afterwards.
Just kind of let it rest in there. Make sure the cables are out of the way.
It's got three slots, or three tabs right here.
Right.
That are basically going to slot in to the bottom of the case.
Do you have to move those fan cables too? Tied up ones there.
There it is.
Or either. I think you're touching the top heat sink there, Barry.
Am I?
I think so.
Come on.
So, oh, you know what I did?
That's what we were talking about.
It's supposed to be all the way that way.
No.
I pointed out the wrong.
Oh, you screwed them into the wrong side, didn't you?
Yep.
Okay. So I'll show you a quick adjustment of where the fans are, or where the radiator is.
Yeah.
And I'll show you.
That is exactly.
Show you what happened. So we have them screwed in right now at this slot right here. What we actually need is we need it pushed back to the back. That way we get the clearance from our motherboard and from our RAM and everything like
right.
that.
Right.
So, just fix that real quick.
Red Mage Cecil was asking, basically, what's our opinion on the motherboard? Is there any reason someone would want this for a consumer level CPU, other than just that it's the best of the best? Well, I think that kind of is the reason you get it. You know, you are. We talked a little bit about it earlier. Essentially, if you're going for the best of the best and you want the 8700K and you want to do an NVMe raid on your SSDs and maybe you want SLI or Crossfire and like you really want to put everything on one board and you need Wi-Fi and you have great audio without having an external setup. I mean, when you start adding up all the things that are on there, the price starts to make a little bit more sense. I mean, a solid DAC and amp is easily $100 or more for an external. You know, having the add-in card for extra M2 would cost you extra aftermarket. Obviously, you know, most boards have Wi-Fi. This has triple LAN ports.
Yeah.
There's just so many different things, and I think the flexibility of the board as well is what kind of lets it make sense.
Right.
You know, for the person who wants to do it all or do a little bit to the highest.
Right. I agree. And it, like you said, it's got stuff built in that, you know, like a DAC and amp that you'd have to have. External sitting on your desk using up a USB port. That's the other thing. This thing has a ton of USB ports.
Yeah, 7+1 type C, I believe.
Yeah, and if you're like me, you use almost about every USB port that your board has.
Yeah, that's honestly the hardest thing for me to do when finding a motherboard is finding out how many USB ports it has on the back. Right. So. Yeah, not to mention it has my favorite feature, which is the LED readout. The screen, so you can see all your stop codes. I much prefer that over trying to plug in a speaker and decipher the Morse code that comes out.
Right.
Plus onboard overclocking.
Yeah, onboard overclocking, plus it's got some push button switches to reset for power, to reset to flashback to your BIOS. You know, so if you're trying some crazy overclock or something like that, you've not got it in your case yet, you've got it setting out on a bench or something like that before you put it in, you know, it's easy for you to do that instead of you having to jump it basically with a screwdriver.
Yeah. And like I said, the little things too, like the I/O shield with a magnet.
Yeah.
I mean, no one's ever done that, like I said, as far as I'm aware.
Right.
So.
Braided SATA cables.
Yeah, braided SATA.
Yeah.
Very few will include that.
All right, I've got this in the right spot now. So I'll pull this back over. Take these cables again and feed them through first. And you do kind of want to keep them in somewhat of an order, because the order that you plug them in is the order that the animation for whatever you choose actually goes on.
Right. So if you do a rainbow or a marquee, anything that's going back and forth, you don't want it to go 1, 3, 2.
Right.
Or...
These are fan cables.
Okay. You get it all routed there?
Yep.
All right. That's what we're looking
there
for.
There we go.
Gently sets into place, stays up on its own, and then now you just secure it.
Right. Now, it's 4 screws to put this back in, but we're also going to have 2 additional screws to finish the mounting for the front panel or the side.
Kind of vanity plate.
Yeah, the vanity plate that we actually moved. So we'll screw in the 4 screws first. All right. Okay, so I have these 2 screw holes right here to finish off. Here's the 4 that we already put in. So now what we need to do, we need to take the CPU, mount it to the block. And before, if you are worried, if you're not using a 360 or using a 280 or something like that, you've got it pushed to the forward. Before you take the plastic cover off, we don't have thermal paste on it, but it's always just a good idea just to reach over, check, make sure it's going to fit, and you're not going to need to slide it or anything like that.
Yeah, set it into place without actually installing it, just to make sure that the tubes are not kinking or getting in the way of anything, touching any fans.
Since thermal paste is not pre-applied, we're using some Arctic MX4, and we'll just do basically just the size of a pea.
There we go. Yeah, nice little curly at the top.
It's an artiste expression.
Yeah.
There we go. Then we'll take our pump. Plug it into the CPU fan header. It's back there, I promise.
It's kind of buried under the fans.
Yeah, it's kind of buried under the fans and under the rad. And so this does have an auto and a PWM setting. It's not software controlled.
Right.
We're leaving it on auto. If we wanted it on PWM, we can control it via the BIOS and the motherboard. We're just going to leave it on auto, let it do its thing.
Yep.
We're going to take our front fan and our rear fan. We're going to plug them into the hub.
Right.
So there are 3-pin, they're not PWM. So just want to make sure you plug them in the right way. So those are done. And now we'll finish up our RGB fans. They come with a, we call this an RGB hub, where you can basically plug in up to 6 of them to be controlled off of 1 hub. The order that you plug them in is important.
Right.
Because if you care about the way that they're going to, if you're going to have them dance or move around or anything like that. So you want to make sure you plug them in 1, 2, 3, preferably in the order that you want them to go, forward or backwards or anything like that.
Like the LED order.
Right. Our front fan is right here. Middle fan. And then our rear fan.
Okay.
Or third fan, not really real rear fan. And then once you have them plugged into here to control them, you need to use the Lighting Node Pro, which comes included, but you need to connect it. So we'll plug one side in here, and then we will plug the other side into, it's got a spot for basically 2 LEDs or two of these controllers or something like that to control your fans. We're going to plug it in number 1, get that guy plugged in, and then the USB 2 that we plugged in earlier, we're going to plug it into the back of it, and then our fans are done. Let's go ahead and plug in our SATA. So we need SATA power for the case fan hub, for our RGB hub, for our Lighting Node Pro. There we go. And then we have one more. We have the SATA cable. So we're going to also put in a Toshiba 3 terabyte traditional hard drive.
Nice.
So just for mass storage. These are the mounts that they come with, but it, you know, obviously you can't put it in here, but it's kind of different and unique. You basically take these 4 grommets out that are in your hard drive tray. You'll take 4 of these screws and then just push these through. We'll flip over the hard drive and we'll screw these into the back of our hard drive. So you can see there, they've just screwed in there, so they're not too tight. And now what we're going to do now, on the back side of this panel right here, you can see that there's some slots going down. So slots in, push down, hard drive's installed.
Yeah, very easy.
Yeah, very easy. It's a little thing, but it's very simple, and I like it a lot. Now we'll plug in our SATA power to our hard drive and our SATA data. There we go. And now we're more or less done with back of the case for right now. Before we put the graphics card in, I do want to go ahead and plug in our RGB strip. Again, this came with the motherboard. Right. It's a Fantex Rainbow strip, and it is addressable RGB through Mystic Light.
Right.
And you want to make sure you line up the little arrow with the ground on the motherboard, which it says ground. It also points it out in the motherboard manual. I'm just going to kind of route this through just a little bit. We'll end up putting it in the bottom of the case, but we're going to wait until our graphics card goes in to put it in there. So we'll just stick it right now.
And as you mentioned, this is an addressable RGB header, which is different than a standard RGB header.
Right, that means each individual LED will change colors opposed to the whole strip changing colors at the same time.
Right.
Our last part, we're going to be using the MSI Seahawk 1080 Ti, which is a 1080 Ti with a 120 millimeter radiator attached to it.
Okay.
Actually, before I pull this out, we're going to go ahead and remove our top 2 PCIe slot covers. So you can't miss them. I suggest pulling them out, just because sometimes when putting it in,
they can
cables.
Yeah, they can interfere with the back here.
Right. So we want to intake through the bottom. The way the fan's set up right now is the intake this way and exhaust. So if we installed it like this, we would actually be exhausting out of the bottom. We want to intake. So we're basically just going to take this fan off and reverse it. You don't want to install the radiator before you install the graphics card, because if you put it too far forward or too far back or something like that, your hoses may kink, may not reach, and you'll just have to take it out.
Right.
Okay. And we do have some nice peels on the card. Well, I say nice. We'll see how well they peel off.
Nice. A little baby peel.
Yeah. To do this, I'm just going to kind of leave the pump kind of dangling. I don't want to kink the cables or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, just open up the, open up the slot on the X16. Just slot it down in. Yeah. Just kind of rest the radiator there for a second.
Right, and you definitely want to secure the graphics card to the case before you start trying to put the radiator in, so it's not moving all over the place or pulling against it.
All right, so I want my cable at the back. Put this in. This is going to be the more complicated part.
generally line them up beforehand, because then you're going to be kind of, you're going to be trying to put the screw in through the fan and hit the radiator. Yeah.
Screw, the case, fan, rad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
Okay.
We're almost there.
Almost there. So we need to still hook the fan up for the cooler down here.
Mm-hmm.
We do need to hook it up to the motherboard. It is not controlled by the graphics card. It's controlled by a header
right
on your motherboard. So, and there's one down here. I'm plugging it in the system fan header number 7. There we go.
So now we have our graphics card power.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Look at our 6-pin.
And the 6+2.
Yep.
And this is just added on because it was a nice touch from the motherboard.
Mm-hmm.
We're just gonna fit it down here. Add a little glow.
Give us just a little glow.
I believe we are good to go.
Yep. Before we reassemble everything on all the sides.
Right.
Give it a quick test boot.
Yes.
There you go.
Yep.
Start button.
Ooh. Ooh, that rainbow glow showing up really nicely. I like that a lot.
We have all our lights. So if we get to the BIOS.
Actually, we'll probably go straight into the Windows.
Yeah. Yeah, actually, the only way I could tell that it was booting up is I heard the hard drive spin. I wasn't sure.
And there we go.
So,
all right, we're in Windows.
All right, so we'll shut it down.
Yeah.
And then put all the side panels back on. Right. Obviously, we'll not be putting the closed section on the top.
Right.
We're gonna, that's where our 360 rad is.
We're going to put the vent back on.
Mm-hmm.
So we can exhaust out the top.
And that's with the fan filter.
Yep. With fan filter. Just push it down, snaps in, pretty simple. There we go. Open up our door. And you can, I don't think I talked about it when we talked about it, but you can reverse the open,
right,
open close
switch,
of the door.
Yeah, you can switch it. So depending on where your case is, if you wanted to pull it from the other side, it's a pretty simple process.
The other benefit of the metal frame around the tempered glass is you're not actually touching the glass.
Right.
So it's going to keep all those fingerprints, for the most part, off.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah. it's so satisfying when those doors close.
And Mystic Light, part of the motherboard, so you can control the different regions. Mm-hmm. With Mystic Light, you can also control our RAM.
Right.
I think certain Corsair keyboards and mice,
yeah,
and the HD fans, you cannot control the ML Pros or the LLs,
right,
that Corsair has.
Right.
We've got our temperatures up and hardware mon. We'll look at those after it runs. That can actually, time spy will actually run through a demo and then run through the actual test.
Okay. And while this benchmark is running, we'll get your final thoughts on building the case and,
right,
and what one, I think about it.
One
as
more
well.
Thing before I forget.
Oh, yes.
Very important. Our Wi-Fi antennas.
Yes.
Just because normally we won't put these on here, but these honestly look so awesome, yeah, that you can't not include. I mean, just look at that thing. I mean, it's just amazing.
Yeah.
10 FPS probably guaranteed.
Exactly.
Thoughts on building in the case. I love it. It's got a lot of room. It's got options for the room. Like if I wanted to have a lot of hard drives, I can have a lot of hard drives. If I don't want any hard drives, I want to do some real serious water cooling. It's got the support for that. It's got the room for that besides the support. One of the reasons we went with a 360 rad in the top and then a 120 millimeter rad in the bottom was just because we wanted to see what the case could do,
right,
realistically and what we had to do. We did have to move the front panel back, or the vanity cover back to kind of accommodate some of that. I think it's worth it. I like it being open like that. Also frees up some of our airflow. Comes with three 140 millimeter fans that we didn't have to take off. Right. So we've still got good airflow coming through, added even more fans.
Yeah, that's a huge benefit to me right out of the box, is that it comes with three 140 mil fans as opposed to, like, a lot of cases, even as they start to get up there in the budget and range, still only have, like, one, maybe two.
Yeah, exactly. So. And if we wanted to stay silent, if we did want to put a rad in the front, we have the option of the Modu vent cover at the top. We've got we can get a vertical riser card for it.
Done right.
Yeah, done right. It mounts to the power supply shroud using standoffs. It's a very nice cable. It doesn't look flimsy or cheap or anything like that. It actually feels very solid. So that's definitely positive. Even if you have to buy it afterwards,
right.
It keeps the cost, I'm guessing it keeps the cost of the case down since they don't bundle it in.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a nice touch. The being able to add USB Type-C afterwards. You know, I don't have anything that's Type-C right now, so I don't need it.
Yeah.
But if I get something later on and I can actually add that to the case, I appreciate that. The little button to pop the stuff off from the top, I like it. Removable radiator bracket, I love it. Makes it a ton easier for installing AIOs and radiators and stuff like that. Cable management in the back, I thought it had plenty of room. I didn't run into any trouble.
Yeah, but, I mean, the back panel just clicked on.
Right. Favorite part of the case, though, would probably have to be the side panels.
Yeah.
And the tempered glass side panel, because I love tempered glass. I'm not a fan of the bolts that you have to put in.
Mm-hmm.
That's the only way people's been doing it, so that's kind of the standard. This is different. It's got a frame. It keeps me from putting my fingers all over the glass when I'm putting it in. And it pops in, and I don't have to put the thumb screws back unless I'm going to travel or something like that with it. Same thing with the back panel. It just pops in. Very simple. No, like, certain latch that you have to get it in and kind of fight it in.
Yeah.
It just kind of goes in, pops in, and you're good to go.
Yeah. And for a smaller mid-tower, really, having EATX support up to 285 millimeters is great. One thing to note is that if you are using it in the standard layout with that vanity plate up front, you can use graphics cards up to 300 millimeters in length. Any longer than that, they have to be under 155 millimeters tall.
Right.
So something to consider if you have a really big and really long graphics card, you'll either have to run it in the open format that we have it, or just remove that plate entirely.
Right. Yeah. The other thing that I like, just because I don't believe I've seen it done like this before, is the hard drive mounting. When you move to the open layout like we have it, just the four simple screws and the grommets, and it just pops in. It's great. Like I said, I still run traditional hard drives in my rig at home, so it's good to see that people aren't completely doing away with them, but not doing them in a way that either just makes cabling a mess or something like that. So that's also greatly appreciated.
Yeah. Aside from that, the reset button is up to you. It's a little too hard for me to press. Obviously, I don't want it to be easy to press, but it's still a little too hard. Barry enjoys it.
Yeah, I don't like to push the reset button on accident. Not that I've ever done that before. I wouldn't like for it to happen. Yeah. The other thing, and this is all going to depend on your taste, which in any case is, the front or the top of the case is kind of a vented look. So you're either going to like it, you're not going to like it, you're going to be kind of like, man, I wish they'd have done something different.
Mm-hmm.
I personally kind of like it. Kind of gives it kind of a race car hood scoop, you know, kind of feel sort of thing like that.
Yeah.
So I don't mind it so much. Other people may, but, you know, it's one of those things that it's just kind of an opinion.
Well, and there's eight different versions of the case, like we said.
Right.
There's the tempered glass and non-tempered glass, which is just a solid side panel. So if you don't want the flare, you just get solid side panels on both sides. And then they have the black and white, the black version, which has some white internals.
Right.
The white version, which is all white with a little bit of black internals.
Right.
And then they have the gunmetal, which is silver gray. And the blackout version, which is all black.
Yeah, fans black, hard drive trays, everything like that.
Yeah, expansion slots, air covers, everything is black. So you have a lot of different options, depending on how you want to design it aesthetically for your build. Yeah, and if you're someone with an R5 right now, this is a significant step up and change from R5 to R6.
I agree.
Whereas, you know, kind of R5 from R4, was more of just kind of a generational update. There were a few nicer things added. This is really almost a different case.
I agree. All right. Time spot is finished running. We got a score of 9,343. Let's take a look at our temperatures. We're down here at the GPU. On the GPU, we had a 55 degree peak, which isn't bad considering what we just ran it through.
Fantastic for
Yeah.
Any
yeah.
GPU.
Yeah, especially it is a 1080 Ti, so those do run
right.
normally hotter, yeah. and we're idling around 35 yeah. degrees, which is great.
So only going up 20 degrees Celsius, I mean, that's why you buy a hybrid card.
Right.
Right there.
Exactly.
Lower temps, higher overclocking potential. Yeah.
And then our CPU peaked at 67, setting at 36, so yeah. perfectly good. Nice and cool. Even though we opened the top, it didn't get overly loud.
Mm-hmm.
Again, we have it set on auto. We don't have it set on PWM. We could right. switch that, go we into the BIOS.
Crank those fans 100% and right. really do some crazy overclocking.
Yeah, exactly. Same thing for the GPU fan. We could put it at 100%. You know, case fans, everything like that. We could yeah. put it at 100%. We just left everything stock what the BIOS is running right now.
Yeah. All right. Well, I think that it just about wraps things up here.
Yep.
Big thanks again to Fractal for providing the case for this build. MSI for providing the motherboard, and Corsair for providing the fans.
Yep.
If you enjoyed our content or learned anything new, please give us a like and subscribe.